I finally told the American Museum people that I had to get home. Hannibal Hamlin, the leader, didn't want to let me go. He had gotten so fond of me and relied so much on my knowledge of birds that he tried everything to make me, but I said nothing doing. So I went on a French copra steamer that was going to go to Marseilles from the Solomon Islands, 7 weeks again. And while I was on this ship, things happened in Europe. Lord Rothschild's curator of birds, Dr. Hartert, had a bad pneumonia, and he was over 70 and decided to retire. So Rothschild had to get a new curator of birds, and he got his network busy, and he got in touch with the American Museum, with the British Museum, with Stresemann, who would be a good young man to take over the bird curatorship at the museum there. Well, somehow or other, finally, they came up with the name of Ernst Mayr. And he's not very experienced, but he's been very successful on his expeditions that he had, these three expeditions in New Guinea, and he's a go-getter, and he will do it, and if it doesn't work out, you can always fire him. So Rothschild, as his niece writes in her biography of Dear Lord Rothschild, decided to hire me to be the curator of birds. But I was on this copra steamer. I knew nothing about it. There was no way to get in touch with me. And before I got to Marseille, things had changed in England. Lord Rothschild was being blackmailed by, as Miriam Rothschild calls it, a titled lady. And he suddenly discovered he didn't have the money for a curator of birds. So before I even reached Marseille, everything was canceled, and everybody was so sorry for me having lost this wonderful job that they wouldn't tell me about it. I learned all this only years later.